What's up, guys? Welcome back. I hope you're in the mood for comfort food because today I'm going to show you how to make crispy buttermilk fried chicken. But before we do that, please take a quick second to subscribe to the channel. Make sure to hit that bell to enable notifications as well. All right, guys, meet me in the kitchen. Let's make it happen. First things first, we need to get to work on our buttermilk marinade. So into a mixing bowl, we're going in with 1 quart of buttermilk. Now, I prefer to marinate my chicken for at least 4 hours, but preferably overnight if you have the time. The buttermilk's gonna add some nice flavor, and the acid in the buttermilk's gonna help break down the chicken and make it nice and tender. To the buttermilk, we're gonna add 1 tablespoon of hot sauce, followed by some cayenne pepper, 1 tablespoon of garlic paste. As always, guys, specific measurements and ingredients are provided for you in the description box below. Going in with 1 packet of sazon as well. I also like to use a little bit of adobo. You can really use whatever seasoning you like on your fried chicken. Of course, we're going in with some of my all-purpose seasoning as well. That's a blend of salt, pepper, garlic, and onion powder, and a couple other spices. If you haven't tried that yet, you can get yours via the link in my description box. There's a discount code for you there as well. Break out the whisk and mix to combine. And speaking of the chicken, today we're using dark meat. I'm going in with some thighs and some drumsticks, but feel free to use this marinade on whatever part of the chicken you like. We all know that chicken wings are super expensive right now, and drums and thighs are a little lighter on the wallet, so that's what we're going with today. So we're gonna add our clean and dry chicken right into that buttermilk. Make sure that it's completely submerged in all that flavor, and then we're gonna pop that in the refrigerator for 4 to 24 hours. Now, while that chicken is hanging out in the fridge, it's time to get our flour together. So we're going in with 2 cups of all-purpose flour and 1/4 cup of cornstarch. The cornstarch is going to help ensure that this chicken is nice and crispy. We're also going in with 1 packet of sazon, some all-purpose seasoning, basically all the same seasonings that we use for our marinade. Again, guys, feel free to use whatever seasonings you like on your chicken, and all the specific measurements and ingredients for this recipe can be found in the description box below, so don't forget to check that out. The real key here, my friends, is to make sure that the flour is adequately seasoned. So get in there with a fork, give everything a good mix, make sure that seasoning is evenly distributed, and then I want you guys to put a fingertip into the flour and taste it. That may sound a little crazy, but trust me, if you don't taste it, you're just guessing, and if I learned anything when I took the SAT test, if you're guessing, you're gonna be wrong. So get in there and give it a taste. If it doesn't taste like it's seasoned before it goes into the oil, guess what? It's not gonna taste season when it comes out. So once you got that right where you want it, we're going to take that chicken from the buttermilk, drain off any excess buttermilk, and then throw it right into that seasoned flour. Get in there with your hands and make sure that it's well coated in that seasoned flour. We don't want any bald spots. I like to use my hands to really press the flour in there. You want to make sure it forms a nice crust around the chicken and stays nice and crispy. Another quick pro tip is to do this about 15 to 20 minutes before you fry the chicken. This does 2 things. It allows the chicken to come up to room temperature, which helps it cook more evenly, and it gives time for that flour to really adhere to the chicken and form a nice crust, which is going to end up in a nice crispy fried chicken and extra juicy. So just repeat that process for all of the pieces of chicken that you plan to fry, and then we're going to get our oil up to 350 degrees. I like to use a deep fryer for this, but you can use a shallow fry method with a cast iron skillet if you want to. This is what the chicken looks like after about 15 minutes. We're going to fill up our deep fryer. This is from Camp Chef. They're not a sponsor, but they make a good product, so you guys can check them out if you want to. We're looking for 350 degrees on the oil, and we know it's 350 because we're using my digital food thermometer. You can grab that via the link in my description box as well. Gently lay the chicken into that 350 degree oil. Don't just drop it in there. We don't want any splatter. There we go. Once you add the chicken to the hot oil, you want to move it around a little bit to ensure it's not sticking to the bottom or sticking to each other. We want optimal crispiness here. So give it a little shake. It's going to fry up in about 9 to 10 minutes, depending on how big your pieces of chicken are. We're looking for a nice golden brown and 175 degrees internal temperature. Oh man, look at that. Say it with me, guys, looking good. I like to drain my chicken on a wire rack rather than a paper towel, because if a paper towel gets soggy, then it's going to end up making your chicken soggy. So using this wire rack allows air to circulate around it and ensures your chicken stays nice and crispy. That, my friends, looks like perfect fried chicken to me. We're going to plate this up, brace yourself for a trademark money shot, and then we're going in for the taste test because I cannot wait to dig into this. Let me know in the comments what you think, what you want to see next. I'm gonna hit mine with a little hot sauce, preferably the Old Bay hot sauce, which is absolutely delicious. Cheers, my friends. Let's go in for the taste test, see what we got. Definitely burned my mouth a little bit, but this is money. Let me know what you think in the comments. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell to enable notifications. And as always, thank you for your support.